As of May 4th of 2025, there are currently 52 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, which produced the second largest explosive eruption of the 20th century, is Guatemala's Santa Maria volcano. The aforementioned powerful eruption in 1902 left behind a giant scar in the main mountain from which a flank lava dome complex known as Santiaguito has grown ever since. Santiaguito has been continuously erupting since 1922, producing repeated volcanic eruptions which often generate pyroclastic flows. During the last week, a new dacite lava flow lobe appeared, which can be seen here. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In India, the nation's only confirmed active volcano erupted anew, ejecting bombs of lava and generating a small lava flow. Meanwhile, a new volcanic eruption occurred in the United States as an eruption of the Atka volcano in the Aleutian Islands was detected. And in what is this week's top story, an explosive eruption in the Philippines caused a layer of ash to fall on nearly 100,000 people. This occurred due to not one, but two explosive eruptions of the nation's third most active volcano, Bulusan. Bulusan had, after 6 months of essentially no activity, produced an unexpected earthquake storm that involved 89 quakes on April 21st, including 4 low-frequency quakes. This swarm was due to the movement of magma and hydrothermal fluids and gas, with the latter building in pressure until it broke through overlying rock 1 week later, causing a phreatic eruption at 4:36 a.m. on April 28th. A 24-minute-long eruption had commenced, generating a pyroclastic flow that traveled 3 kilometers or 1.86 miles to the west-southwest, stopping 1,400 meters from the closest structure. Ash from the eruption rose into a 6,096-meter or 20,000-foot-high plume which subsequently drifted to the west and west-northwest, causing a trace to 1 millimeter thick of ash to fall on select towns within a 25-kilometer radius. As a result, Bulusan's alert level was raised from 0 to 1 on its 0 to 5 scale. 39 hours and 7 minutes later, a second phreatic eruption occurred, this time involving a lower eruption plume but a larger explosion, causing around a centimeter of ash to fall on nearly 300 people. This larger phreatic eruption lasted for 77 minutes and caused a layer of ash this time to fall on the west-southwest instead of west-northwest. More phreatic eruptions, most likely of a similar intensity, have the potential to occur at Bulusan across the next few days to weeks, with this possibility being supported by its elevated sulfur dioxide emissions. Meanwhile, in Alaska, a new volcanic eruption began at the Atka volcano on April 25th, creating an explosion detected by the local volcano monitoring network, which is shown on screen. This small phreatic eruption occurred 12 miles north-northeast of the small town of Atka, population 50, at 6:33 p.m. local time, specifically originating from its Korovin cone. Korovin is the most active vent of the overall volcanic complex, which consists of 4 stratovolcanoes and 2 satellite stratocones. In historic times, only 19 eruptions have been observed, 3 from Klyuchev, which last erupted in 1995, and 16 eruptions from Korovin. This week's eruption is the second to occur of the year, perfectly fitting the description of a small VEI-1 phreatic eruption. While more explosions could follow during the next few days to weeks, this is far from a certainty. While the Korovin vent has not shown any signs of life since, Atka's alert level was raised from green to yellow on April 25th. And in India, the nation's only volcano with a confirmed historical eruption, which is known as Barren Island, erupted anew. This unpopulated, almost stereotypical tropical island volcano contains a central cone, a small caldera, lush rainforest at its caldera edge, and young-looking lava flows. After going on a lengthy hiatus after 1832, Barren Island erupted again in 1991, which initiated a highly active period that has continued to the present. This means that in every year since 2005, if we exclude 2012, that there has been a point in time in which Barren Island was actively erupting. The latest eruption seemingly began on April 24th, 2025, and while I could not get any visuals of the island, to me it looked like several lava bombs were ejected, potentially even generating a lava flow that moved slightly towards the west of its central cone. However, after activity peaked on April 25th, activity declined, although it still does appear to be erupting at a low intensity. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on May 3rd of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.